a prophet's message. Before Zeniff died, he gave the kingdom to his son Noah. King Noah was wicked. He got rid of his father's priest and chose prideful priests to take their place. Noah and his priest had many wives. Through their bad examples and flattering words, Noah's priest taught the people it was okay to sin. The people had to give one-fifth of all they had to support Noah, his priest, and their many wives. Noah also built many fancy buildings. The Lamanites began to attack the people. When Noah's armies beat the Lamanites, they bragged about how strong they were. God sent Abinadi to warn the people. He told them to repent or they would become slaves to their enemies. King Noah and his people were angry with Abinadi and tried to kill him. But the Lord helped Abinadi get away. After waiting 2 years, Abinadi returned and told them that they would become slaves and be destroyed if they did not repent. The people did not think they had sinned. They thought they were too strong for their enemies. Abinadi was put in prison. The priest questioned Abinadi, hoping to find something wrong with his words. His answer surprised them. When asked about a scripture, Abinadi asked why they pretended to teach God's words if they did not understand them. When the priest said they taught the law of Moses, Abinadi asked why they loved riches and harlots and did not keep the law of Moses. King Noah wanted to kill Abinadi, but Abinadi said, "Touch me not." He was not finished giving God's message. Because of the Spirit of the Lord that was with Abinadi, King Noah and his priests were afraid to touch him. Abinadi warned that whatever they did to him would also happen to them. Then he taught them the Ten Commandments. Noah's priest said the law of Moses could save them, but they weren't even keeping the law of Moses. Abinadi said the law was given to help the children of Israel remember God and to teach them about Christ. Abinadi taught that God would come to earth as a man. He would do miracles, suffer for the sins of his people, be killed, and rise again. Christ's people listen to the holy prophets and believe Christ will redeem them. Abinadi said many things to the priest. He told them that there will come a day when the Lord will judge everyone fairly. The wicked will be cast out, and the devil will have power over them. The righteous will be happy and live with God. When Abinadi finished speaking, the king told his priest to burn Abinadi. Elmah, one of Noah's priests, believed Abinadi. He pled with the king to let Abinadi go in peace. But this made the king more angry. Noah sent his servants to kill Elmah, but Elmah escaped. He hid and wrote all the words of Abinadi. King Noah told Abinadi he would suffer death by fire if he did not take back his words. Abinadi would not take back his words. As he started to burn, Abinadi said the families of Noah's priests would also burn and cause many who believed in God to suffer death by fire. Abinadi sealed the truth of his words with his death.